All right, guys, so I'm here at Monster Aquarium, and just walking through the doors here, I'm absolutely blown away by the selection of fish here. I had to show you guys. I'm also going to introduce you to the owner, John. He's going to tell you guys exactly where this is, because you guys got to come check it out here in New York.
John, what's the store called, and where are you guys located?
13108 40th Road in Flushing, New York.
And you guys are open seven days a week,
including holidays.
Awesome. So I have a lot of fish here that I really like, but I got to know, from the owner's perspective, we have a lot of the same taste in our fish, clearly. But what are some of the fish that you like or that really stand out to you here in the store?
All types of platinums.
Platinums.
Rhinos, rares.
Yes. So I did see you had some platinum the silvers. There's platinum silver arowanas. You got the platinum knives. Absolutely incredible selection.
And on that note, I'm going to take you guys through a tour of this store. Now, this was taken a couple of months ago when I was in New York. Justin, we just passed him right there. He actually took me around to a bunch of fish stores and just for me to check them out. I was really excited to do so, especially to come to this store. I heard a tremendous amount about it, and I needed to check it out for sure. With that said, the owner didn't know I was coming. We didn't prep anybody. I didn't even really plan on filming, so I didn't really bring a good camera or good audio equipment, nothing like that. But once I was there, I absolutely had to capture it, had to film it, and share with you guys what I saw. So right now, I'm only taking you through a walkthrough of the layout of the store, so when we're looking at individual fish, you'll get a better idea of what we're looking at. I will say that this is the type of store that, you know, had all kinds of fish that I've always wanted to keep, never even seen in person, so this is a great experience, and again, I had to share it with you guys. But while there, I heard there was a downstairs, and, you know, to me, all the best stuff's always kept downstairs, right? So I went downstairs, checked that out as well. Pretty impressive, got to admit. Now, I should also say in advance that this is the first time I looked at this footage in a couple of months, so I'm really just going to watch it with you guys. I really enjoyed, we did this one time before, and I really liked the format. Just kind of kick back and look at the fish, and hopefully there's some better footage once we get moving, but I do know that we take a closer look at the tanks in a second when we go back upstairs. When you walk in the front doors, some scaping supplies to the left, but to the right was this big cube tank. Housed a bunch of tiny fish and nicely aquascaped, and almost gave you the illusion that, you know, this is going to be a, you know, not monster fish, but a bunch of tiny fish, but that wasn't the case. With that said, there is a bunch of, this store carried everything, you guys are going to see that. Bottom left, we got a scar shark, we got some tinfoil barbs, it's got some parrotfish in there, you know, some red terrors. Up top was some African cichlids, just a mixture of them. These guys were really nice too. I did notice that they were doing continuous water changes at all times. They had drip systems running. They were doing big water changes on the tanks. This tank was pretty cool. They had some, this is just a regular silver arowana up top, but they had some albino knives on the bottom, some big bass in the backs. They had some knives, some more Oscars. And don't get it confused. These are only holding tanks. Look at giant gouramis right there. Look at the big lips on them. So these are only holding tanks. You know, Waru, if you guys seen that. So these are, like I said, they're just holding tanks. Oh, there's an albino or a platinum silver arowana. Another one up there. Very beautiful. Very, very nice. Lots of parrotfish. So let me just get that out of the way. They're holding tanks. They're not there for life. I mean, they're just being housed in here until they're sold. Not a big deal. These guys do massive amounts of water changes. And again, if I had a big pet store and keeping these types of fish, this is pretty much exactly how I'd do it too. Off from the monster fish, let's take a look at some of the smaller tanks. We got in here some tetras. They had actually a good selection of small fish as well and plants. Pretty impressed with that. Down low, I think we got some geophagus to the right. We got some angels here. What have we got up here? Baby peacock bass. These guys are adorable. Now, keep these guys in mind for a minute when we go downstairs. And this too. These are like baby alligator gar. Adorable at this size, aren't they? You guys remember the story of mine that jumped through the top of my tank, broke the glass. These guys become absolute beasts. And some puffers in here to the left, I think. keyhole cichlids. Another, that's the Jardini in there, arowana. Really cool fish. Silver dollars. Oh, the exodons. I should have looked at those closer. They're to the tank to the left, or to the right. Some more catfish. Parrots. You guys seen the bigger ones there, and this is, you know, they're pretty cute at that size. I actually, you know, just to confess, I've kept them in the past. I haven't kept them lately, but Flowerhorn, got to take a look at these guys. These guys are only $45. Believe it or not, he's got even better ones there on the other side of the rack when we get there. Clownfish. Those guys look great when they're in big groups. Good, nice little selection of plants there. I kind of skipped over the planted tanks because they just had plants in them, but some big knives. These guys get so big. Some more arowana up top. I couldn't sit still. Some Bosmani rainbows. I couldn't sit still through this tour. I had to look at every tank. Every tank I looked in, I got more and more excited. Some angels, more plants on the bottom. See a pleco tank there. I think we go around the corner here in a second. And here we go. Yeah. More tinfoil barbs, more clowns, more gar. These guys are pretty cool. Get so big, though. It's so big. A lot of these guys do. Now look at these guys. Look at these flowerhorn. Aren't they cute? Now there's one in here I remember. I keep thinking about him. I'll know him when I see him. But he's one of the fish that stood out. Oh, there he is. That's got to be him. Yeah, that guy right there. Look at him. Beautiful. He's only tiny, too. Maybe 3 or 4 inches. Look at the potential. He's only $65. What? That's like a $300-$400 fish, in my opinion. Anyways, there's a ton of great prices in here. Fish were really good priced. That's probably why he's able to keep so many, because he prices them so well and moves them so quick. That was a mixed tank, wasn't it? It had some datinoids, some sharks, some gourami. Oh, I remember this. Okay, up top there was some panda waru. Yes, right. You guys know I love waru. My channel name is Waru Joey, in fact. But some datinoids in here. Beautiful. The panda waru are definitely one of the most difficult fish to keep. Far more sensitive for higher requirements. So a lot of times when I'm at these pet stores, I'll skip by the tetras because it's just so hard to show them up on camera and get a good focus when I don't have a good camera with me. There's some dwarf gourami and flame gouramis in there. Those are always cute. These are electric blue acaras, I believe. Yeah, I think, well, there's half the label there. But these guys are beautiful. The lighting isn't showing them off that great, but man, do they have an iridescence about them. Okay, so right off to the corner here, this was some sunshine plecos. I think they are L014. This is off the top of my head, but they're sunshine plecos. That was a giant gourami. Look at this guy, platinum alligator gar. Whew, I've never seen one in person. Little red-tailed catfish behind him. Beautiful, beautiful fish. If I was to keep an alligator gar again, it would have been him. I'd just do it. Jump through my tank if you have to. It's outside now. Maybe I should get one. I don't know. Ugh, I feel like I'm at the store now and I'm about to do an impulse buy. convincing myself it's going to be okay. Okay, so this was a really interesting section for me. You guys know I've kept the goldfish in the past and I advocated for them. And I've been contemplating getting mine back from a friend of mine that I basically housing with them. He'd keep them no matter what, though. But with that said, when I came into his the goldfish selection here and got to see like some really high-end, high-quality fish, and I'm not that well-versed with goldfish, but man, these guys were beautiful to me. Really good prices as well. I just started thinking, well, maybe I should get some higher-end, higher-quality type goldfish, and these guys were huge. They're like as big as your like two fists. It was hard to give an idea of their size, but these guys were too mammoths. I really like these. I think those are like red cap or nandas, maybe. Oh man, I'm probably get roasted for being wrong, but again, I'm not well versed with goldfish. Of course, I got to take a look at the filtration. I'm always interested in how things work and what are they doing differently. And you know, that's something you should do as well, is not just look at the fish, but see how everything works next time you're at your pet store. I know it's it can be distracting at times, but there's always something to learn. You don't have to do it, and you don't have to agree with it, But just learning is a good idea. So know our goldfish. Yeah, so I don't know. I need to really seriously think about what I want to do here. Do I want to get goldfish like this, or do I want mine back? Because mine will never look like this. Mine were, you know, discount type fish where you just buy 30 or 40 of them. You don't know what you're going to get. Variety bucket type thing. Of course, this saltwater tank was really nice. Didn't have a ton of saltwater, but he did have some. I might have skipped over a little bit of it, and, you know, maybe I didn't see as much as I could. I'll admit, you know, I was a little bit overwhelmed with, you know, wanting to go back to look at the fish I really liked instead of showing you guys everything, but it is what it is. I really liked his fish, his dry goods selection. I remember filming this. Yeah, I remember coming in here and being like, oh, that's nice that he's got, you know, tanks set up, and, you know, you kind of mess around with them, but, ugh, look at that wood. You guys know I love to show off my wood. You had some great wood there. Lots of Malaysian bogwood up there. Oh, these tanks were sexy. I remember these. So these were these all-white, high-gloss tanks. I didn't show them that well, but they were digital up top. I don't know what they cost, but they were really nice. I'm pretty sure they were probably a good cost based on what I've seen so far. Now downstairs. I believe we go back upstairs for a second to look at some other fish, but downstairs was interesting because I got to see some fish I haven't seen before. I knew all about them and I've wanted them before, but never got a chance to actually see them. So these are some datinoids. I've had one before, and you're going to see the datinoids not looking that great. They're kind of a moody fish, kind of like Oscars. They'll lay on their sides. You see some little peacock bass in there. Discus. Got to get discus again. I kind of grew out of discus, though. I did quite a bit with them because some albino arowana. These are silvers. I don't think I'd do a silver arowana again. I go black arowana because they don't get the drop eye. And they stay a little bit smaller, about 2 feet. That's if I couldn't keep Asian arowana. Look at these guys. Look how cute they are at this size. This is the Goliath tigerfish. They're going to get massive, and they're going to get this big row of teeth that bite through your arm. It's crazy to see them at that size. Little turtles. They're always so adorable. I gotta get a turtle. Or six, probably, knowing me. What's I doing here? More discus. You know, a lot of times when I'm filming this stuff, I forget that I'm filming and I'm just gawking around and enjoying it myself, so bear with me. More discus here up top. I think somebody was talking to me or something. Should have told him to leave me alone. Oh, it was John who was going to show me some fish. Yeah, so he has some datinoids in the back there. More discus. You can kind of get an idea of how good discus can look on a white background here. So I've done white with mine, or blue, or they definitely look good on solid colors, that's for sure. But really good selection there. This was an interesting tank. But up top, this is what I was going to tell you about. These are red mammons, I believe. The mammon is what they're called. So they look like big parrotfish. And I guess, you know, arguably they almost kind of are. But they're definitely a different type of fish. They get bigger than the parrot. They don't have the bubbled body shape to the extent. They don't have the deformed mouth as much. And they stay redder longer. We got a VJ up front. We got striped tilapia in the back. That's a giant gourami up front there. Some big datinoids. Some big, there's a big peacock bass off to the left there, too. What else do we got here? He's got one mean fish coming up here soon, and that's how we're going to end off this video. But, I remember. I wasn't even recording audio during this. That's why we're doing a voiceover. Now I remember. My bad. So this guy, one of the meanest fish you could put in your fish tank. This is a wolf fish. It got a mean name, and it's a mean fish. And if you look closely, you can see its teeth. Just a mean, mean fish. Anyways, guys, that was my store tour of Monster Aquarium. I certainly enjoyed visiting that store and getting to relive this footage with you guys. And if you enjoyed it as well, let me know in the comments section below.